alternative to an economy and to a currency that you can use and pay things in a better way. So you need to use it in that way, to be always focused in what you are working. As I told you, whenever you go to a project, very easily people are going to distract you with other things that they want you to observe, that they want you to know. There are things that they think is not even important for you to see, or they don't want you to see or to think of. You need to be focused. There are, in each project, there are thousands of things you can think about. When you think about immigrants, you can think of thousands of things, okay? Losing the culture, losing their religion, losing their faith, losing currency. No, it's a lot about lots of things. It's about having relations with other countries, lots of things. You need to be focused on what you want from this project. If you are not focused, you are going to be lost. Of that, it's going to make you lost about everything. So one of the methods of being a good observer is to be focused on what you want to observe, not to think of everything and at its time. Think of solution. You are focused here, you know you are going to observe, it's just to look at the solution, how you are going to solve this problem, and then how you can generalize this model.
A model yani each team, I would say it in a different way, each team need to be يعني really confident that they're gonna bring a solution. Okay, يعني okay. And now today you are hesitating. The more you sit down with your team, the more you try, be more confident, because you really nobody has thought it in this way. Okay, nobody has thought it for sure in Bihaj in this way. So don't worry that you will be the expert. Even not the jury, not the expert, not the mentor. You guys, the team leaders, you are the experts. So don't worry about that you are wrong. No, feel that you'll make a solution, you'll make a solution. Okay, so start with the intention. I am going to make a legacy for Bihaj. I am Iqbala, I am Amina, and so on. Okay, I'm going with this intention. It makes a lot of difference.
Okay, and any model can be generalized. The model that method what was used here with the pipes was used with, for example, the poisoning project can be used with another project. So same models can be generalized, then after we generalize it, we hope to do more publication of it so others can learn from it. And of course, as we talk about project evaluation, visualizations, and all these things we talked about, maybe this one I need to focus more about. That's why what we are doing about the pre-workshop that we are doing now, during workshop, and later on, we need to have observation in each and every step we are going on. What you are trying now, you're trying to observe before going into your project. You are trying to observe and think about things in a different way, in a different method. So when you go to each project you will start with, you are going to go there with a different mindset. You need to make unlearn. If you go with the knowledge, you say, I'm an expert in this field. I'm an expert in the field of migrant. I know everything about it. If you go with this mindset, you can't observe. So what you are trying now to do, you need to do the unlearning to be ready to observe. You make the pre-observation that you want to do. Then you will be ready to go during this. And during the workshop, you can modify things better. You can do the evaluation and you can make the method of follow-up in a better way. And then from there, we need to work what we've just started and decided in the beginning of the session today, that there are going to be even a meeting for us after September, after the forum, how we are going to follow up to sustain these projects. It's not only about having and working on these projects now, not only during the forum, it's also about how we will keep them sustained later on.
Okay.
شنو؟
Most of them are waiting from the house because of some of the water. We want at least one team member to meet us so that he can do this thing. After inshallah, 3:15, we'll do that. This is number one, this first meeting. Second meeting will be meeting another synergy. We'll meet together, inshallah, maybe by early September. I hope by early September we'll come back, right? maybe first week, first day of September. So that we meet again to make sure that every team has done some work that we agreed on. Then we'll have, of course, the last, before one day from starting the forum, again, final teams meeting together, okay? So that we are ready for those with those coming from outside the house. Then we'll have during the forum, which will be together, inshallah. Then directly after the forum is another meeting, the support meeting, which will be after the forum to make sure we are sustaining the model. Okay? And how we can do about it in June. Okay? Once you met, we work together till June, inshallah, which is detailed in the planning through Amr and Najat and our friends, our preparation partners in the University of the International Office, then of course, inshallah, we will get much better results. I want to cover another example, and then we can discuss about what team members have done, okay? So that you don't get bored about يعني talk about theory. Lots of theory there, but I think we'll give it to you يعني, step by step, and instead of you know, feeling that, that this is difficult. Because as whatever I'm explaining, we call it common sense, by the way. It's nothing to do with the science, it's not rocket science, it's only expertise in the field. Whatever I am writing is from my experience trying things in the field. So inspiration lab we did on black spots for traffic accidents. Okay, so I cover two types of solving problems, different ways, and traffic accidents. Traffic accident in Bahrain was increasing a lot. Okay, actually we put a strategy for traffic, which is I'm sure that now every country having a national strategy for managing traffic accidents, or traffic or roads okay, in general. So it reduced a lot. Reduced from 2,081 person to fatal accidents, okay, till to 1,772, okay. Still, as you can see, for a population of 1.2 in Bahrain, it is very high. Okay, so you can see the rate per population is very high. So what when they show me the statistics, and they are happy about it, the government and so on, I always say, so what? And maybe this is one of the questions you should ask yourself when you are doing observation. If someone shows you data, it's time to ask so what. It's either will tell you a good data, or it will tell you it's like a filter. So ask so what. Is this data really important? Because sometimes don't be misled with the data. Whether this data from your observation as I, or data that has been given to you from the entity that you are visiting, or you know the from the team members and so on. Okay. We find, for example, and here I started to show. What is the problem of Bahrain? Bahrain is one of the highest countries in the Arab world, even though with number of population, this is Bahrain. Our population is less than these countries. Still, we are having highest rate, one of the highest rates as per the World Bank statistics and fatal accidents. So here, we said so what again, why we said saying so what? Or, even Bahrain compared to other countries, the best, one of the best countries maybe in controlling one of the worst countries, by the way, Austria. See, Austria is one of the worst countries. And Bahrain is one of the, compared to population, Bahrain is put as one of the worst countries in fatal accidents. Okay. And Belgium. And these are the type of fatal accidents that we have in Bahrain. As I said, and Bahrain used to be one popular country in putting seat belts, following the law. You know, the law is not like you know, our neighbor Saudi Arabia, for example, where they drive really. Really crazy. I showed what is that how they do the road. Okay. So this is an example of what fatal accidents is happening. When we go and study fatal accident, trying to this word in Arabic istikshaf means discover. Okay, trying to discover something that we are not seeing. We've started to see the designs of the road. Because why we've seen the designs of the road? Because the cases of fatal accidents is three causes of you, right? Either the person or the design of the road. Or it is again the environment itself. Okay, so we'll see about that in general. We've seen, for example, in a certain roads, we taken for example those roads that is their speed is limited, and we've seen certain roads they don't have accidents. Accidents has been reduced with time. We started to see the design of the road. Why these roads are? This is what I call again appreciating inquiry using this technique now. Okay, why these roads having? Less number of accidents, even though they have the same amount of flow of traffic. Okay, so this is a way of studying what is happening here. And we started to see also why in certain years Bahrain had less fatal accidents than previous years. As you can see, the red one is the fatal accidents, the black one is the number of cars that is increasing in Bahrain. Okay? And see, we started to see that focus. We call it this learning area. Okay? Or one point lesson. We call it in Japanese, translating to what Japanese said, we call it one point lesson. You focus on this point where something happened good, not something happened bad. So as I told you, causes of accident either from human error, which is usually internationally said, 80% from human error, maximum. Suppose every country have 80% from human error, especially a human error with drinking and so on. In our countries, we should suppose not to have, but still we have error. Okay. And then also because of the car design or because of the road design. Car design is 10%. This is the international road safety whatever blah blah organization. This is a publication from their own calculation and noticing in this in the last 10 years. In Bahrain, we had 93 caused because of, they claim, because of human error. Okay, so here is 80%. Internationally, they say you shouldn't be, while here, claim of the government, okay, says it's 93. When you see a data like this, you should doubt the data. Usually, we don't doubt the data a lot, okay? But when you see a data like this, then here might be something that I need to go deeper. Okay? Because 93% either it might be true, this is a major problem where I can work on, or it might be wrong because of the way of the data collected. Okay, because the government, that is why I'm doing just good, because of the sake of time, I will not tell you how I discovered it later. Who are interested, I can go case by case. Because of the government, they don't know how to calculate, because the people who take the accidents, we don't have proper arbitrators, we don't have proper policemen who take the. So always they put it because of people. They never put it because of the government design of the road, or they never put it because of the standard of the car. They always put it people, okay, accidents. So for that, it comes 93. And for that, we had to go. See, they say because of the car design, well, in America, you'll not find this. Okay? They say because of the car design, it's only 1% because of the car design. While in reality, for that, you see that most of the car recalls start from America and sometimes from Europe, but mainly from America. Why? Because the Americans, the arbitrators, first they will doubt not only the human, they will doubt the car design. Okay? While our police capacity, their capability, they cannot do that. We are not educated anymore. Okay. Or we don't have traffic engineers properly and so on. And for that here, we started the project. This is a good project because there is lots of data problems, lots of problems around. So this is an interesting project for me. I don't take any problem. I take projects like this, which is having problems that cannot be solved by logical thinking. Okay. I just skip for the sake of time. So what I did first, believe it or not, Bahrain didn't have this map before, which you call maybe Bihar does not have this map also. And you can use this technique a lot in your projects, okay? For example, I'm continuing on the just example of migration. I want to see where is the migration happening from which, maybe even road or which city of Bihar?
Graduate of which school?
Okay, graduate of which schools, for example, happening. What type of people, what type of demographics that is relevant to migration, okay? For example, and this is what we call it black spots. Okay, I put it in red, but it is black spots, they call it, where accidents has been repeated in Bahrain. Fatal accidents, I'm talking about. So you can use this type of technique. You see the repeat validation I put in two cases, which is a bit similar technique. So that you can use this in your projects. And we notice, for example, that the area, this area, because it's highly populated, it is, as you can see, it is the area where there is lots of black spots in each other. Lots of fatal accidents areas that is happening here. Also, you need to think, as I told you, not customer end. Customer end means they want good roads. And customer end, they want the best safety for the customer, even though he might be not awake. Because we have lots of roads, which I did not tell you, they come from behind to have some time, okay, to enjoy their time. So, usually, in these areas where we have lots of accidents, they get drunk and at night and so on, and there is lots of fatal accident because of that. We cannot. The easiest thing to, for Bahrain, what they used to do, they say, "Khalas, we'll not deal with the Saudis. We'll stop the Saudis. We'll close the bars of second." This is what they did, by the way, actually. They closed the bars for first and second and third class hotel or four star, three star hotel, because they want to eliminate it to four star or five star. But this is not a solution in reality. Okay. So this is again.
Close this also.
Sorry?
We have to close this also.
Mobile.
Yeah,
right,
of course. Yeah. Yes.
Same.
Yes. Of course. So when you think, see the difference between end customer and you have to take care that this customer in different conditions, at night, the morning, whether he's coming from Bahrain, from outside Bahrain, whether there is proper road, whether he knows there is proper signs, you have to take care about customer in different situations. That is what we call it end customer, not customer end one. Okay. Is this clear for you? Right? So this is very important type of thinking to solve a problem. And this is called empathy. Not thinking about customer in one situation, thinking about customer in different situation. Like when you deal with your mother or your father, or you deal with your husband and so on, okay? Or your wife. You deal with different, you expect that you're taking lots of elements around that to make a decision. Okay, as I said, even without he's asking me for water, or she's asking for water, I'll give her the water, I'll give him the water at the right time because I did with him. I buy wine with him, so I know when he's thirsty or not. It's called empathy. So one of the things we did in Bahrain, we made what we call a definition. And this you might need in your project. For example, what means migration for Bihaj? What means migration? This migration means leaving the country totally for good? Or this migration means coming and going and but not staying most of the time in Bihaj? What means migration? I don't think there is one definition for migration in Bihaj. So you need to define what means migration, because if you don't define this, we're not solving a problem for us. So going to a word called taxonomy. Taxonomy means the hub in Mahani Ta'rif.
Dove desumiamo con catalogo per il preserato che definisci la cifra?
Taxonomy, you know taxonomy, yeah. So this is means very important. So one of the things we got to all the stakeholders relevant to car accidents. Who do you think the stakeholders that is relevant to car accidents?
Insurance company.
Police, traffic, right? What else?
Kad su pitanje ove saobraćajne nesreće, ko su ljudi koji bi trebali da utjecaju znači na
disability? But you know, we have in Bahrain also, works department, works ministry, ministry of works, okay, which is they do the roads beside the municipality. Sorry?
Drivers.
Drivers, taxi drivers, all the taxi drivers, okay, schools, right? Because lots of fire dependent accidents happen near the schools and so on. So we go to all the stakeholders and we bring them together and we redefine, and we agree on one definition for what means fatal accidents or black spots. Because there was no proper definition between all the police saying something, and of course Ministry of Works saying something, and you know the school saying something else. So for that we defined this and we agreed on one definition to create what means fatal accident and black spot. Based on this, we started to define, and this is again from actual data. We brought lots of data from Ministry of Works and police, and we unified the data, and we defined where are the roads that is most fatal. Okay, to make that the drawing that I showed you, I brought lots of data and brought it together and put it in one Excel sheet. Okay, to show them that this is the areas where you should now take care about. Okay, because the idea is that we want to minimize, we want to make Bahrain, I call them this, the, maybe you have a project slogan for your team. Okay, I want Bihaj to be smoking free.
Yes.
Okay, for example, okay. This one thing. Or I want Bihaj to be, for example, more of a fatal accident-free kind of city. Example. So this one I brought for Bahrain, that will be fatal-free. Fatal-free means there will be lots of black spots or red spots in the map. So I started with a big map, which is there is lots of actual reality now. Okay. I collected the data and put it. And you'll find, by the way, you have purpose to dig for the data and represent it. They will not give you a proper data the way you want it. Because they are thinking in a different way. You want to take a raw data and represent it in a different way. Okay? What I wanted to show here, of course, this one, the government does not like they don't like this, right? Government. Do they like this? They don't like this. But this is where I show the problem, how much I started with the problem, and how many black spots is increasing behind. I said, it is the whole map, isn't it? So we want to minimize it now. And this is my project. And how much I'm managing to minimize this over time, to minimize the black spots. So I'm removing black spots time by time by starting with model. So I take, I'm not going to do all of this because I'm not empowered. I don't have the power. I'm not the minister of works. I'm not the minister of police. But what I can do a model for one road. Okay. I can do a model in one area. And from this area, I can tell them, see, you can do this. And this is my power. Okay, your power is to do a model only. So remember, it's not solving the problem. It is going only you are going to do till June next year, only doing a model that will involve the world with respect. Say, okay, I want to learn from this case study. Okay? The other maybe issue about observation that is Dr. Bingo mentioned about, which I want to elaborate on. Your observation has to be appreciated from all different specialties. Because it is an inspiring observation, the physician might learn from, the lawyer might learn from, the student might learn from, and blah, blah. Okay? So it has to be an observation that is understood by all parties. Okay. So based on this, we started to go by the roads now, and I started to put the name of the roads. So for example, these are the name of the main roads, where fatal accidents and where they are potential area for my model. Okay? I will not eliminate the model, I take the model very quickly. So choosing the model after observation is choosing where is the model that I'm going to do my model. Okay? So I put all the potential models or roads that I will do, and I start to describe what is happening in this road. What is why this road having fatal accidents? Not depending on the engineers, not depending on the police, but going myself with them to show them how to observe the wrong mistakes, what is happening. Okay, by seeing the design of the road, I will go and see now by what is what's happening. So we started to, first, before I go, I take in the maps. Okay, again, I am not expert in maps. So I tell them, is this road okay? This road, will it cause accident or not? Because I cannot observe some time myself. Okay, I need other people to help me observe. So they say, no, this road, because it is like this, like our road yesterday. Okay, this is less than, worse than our road, Mona road, like this. Okay, because this road, like this, most potentially will create an accident, because driving like this. Especially if the driver is, or as I have a, you know, Arabic regard, especially if the driver is drunk, right? The driver is drunk, it will cause more accidents. Usually they would blame the driver, but we are not blaming the road, right? So in order to think about the drivers, that some of the drivers will be drunk, and take care about them, because they are humans at the end of the day, okay, then we should take care of that this road might be driven not by normal people. When I design it, I have to design it or modify it to take care of even drunk people or people who will go, you know, sick or something else. And this is what's happening. We start to see what we can do in order to specify these areas where we can improve the road design. We go into this road, the same road I'm explaining now, about this same road, we go into this road, and we go down to see what is the accident. This was an accident that when we go on, we see it. Okay, so to show you that it's not everyday accidents. Of course, you know this formula, right? The more you are having accidents, and incidents also, okay? Fatal accidents does not happen very often, right? For example, every 100 accidents, there will be one fatal accident, okay? So the more you have accidents in this road, the more you're gonna create a fatal accident, right? Agreed or not? You got what I'm saying? This formula is formula for health and safety. The more you have accidents, the more you're gonna have fatal accidents with time, okay? So this road is, as you can see, they have this, and from looking at this, this is one of them, might be fatal accidents. Maybe the driver was there, we asked about the driver anyway, he had a broken lip, a broken episode, okay? But based on that, we have noticed that the road, these ones are already, they are painted, but they are not painted only paint. So it is a paint, it's not something that to wake the driver. You know the type of paint that wake the like this, right? So this is, it was not like that. If he's a drunk driver, he will not care about this paint already. Or not a normal driver, a fast speed driver. It doesn't matter for him. So this is again one of the things we started to see. So what we did, and this is again the team, they should show that really they are inspiring team. Because you're going to build an inspiring story, not a success story, remember. Your job, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you to create a success story. But your job is to create an inspiring story. By showing the challenges, how much worse this situation was, and how much you're trying to improve, and by showing that you are trying to do short-term measures, not only long-term measures. Long-term measures is in the hand of bureaucrats or whoever will take decision or on, so on. But short-term measures is in your hands, which we call it an inspiration here, counter-measure. We do not measure, we counter measure. We try to solve a problem in 1 year as much as you can. You minimize the problem as much as you can. We call it counter measure. Based on this story, we started to see, because we did this story, because we did this, we found that this is it. So what they did at the end of the day, they started to paint a different way. They painted the one, just thick one, which is wake up the driver when he's going through the round. We started to take similar cases in different cities in Bahrain. Okay, this is what Dr. Dunia was talking about, generalizing the model. Now we start to feel, we can do also this thing before we close the team. Okay, yes, sir. We have Najab with us. Okay, so here example of one of see this roundabout. There's lots of accidents happen. This roundabout, we have lots of people coming from university and from government, and they're going to their houses. This is the housing area of the government, municipality houses. Okay, and we can see that they're coming from highway with high speed. This is the highway. They come with high speed and the roundabout. And in this roundabout, there's lots of accidents happening. Okay? When we studied this roundabout, okay, you can see this is the roundabout before. Okay? And you can see this driver will enter. This is people coming from highway. There's a traffic light here, and people come here. And usually, this guy, he might want to turn this left, right, and this guy want to go left. So mostly, there's a lot of accidents here. Okay? What countermeasure you think I can do now? I want to minimize, I want to sleep this night, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh, Muhammad or his team have done something about it. Okay, because I don't know if I will live tomorrow or not. So what I did, I brought these, what do you call them? The cones, okay? And I put it in the floor to show, okay, let's let this guy go directly, and he have to take some time till he go into left, and this guy also same time to take care on the right, okay? As if now taking a direct solution before changing the road. Because changing the road will take maybe 1 month, 2 months, maybe 1 year if the government is so. Maybe they will not agree even to change it, okay? Because there will be ego issue. By the way, remember, you're going to deal with ego a lot, with yourself and with others. The ego will start with yourself. No shame that you know that you're doing a mistake you did. No shame if you tell me today, Hamad, you should have improved your worship. Because you're going to have a hand with me. You are a consultant for me. You're getting a consulting, three consultants. When you tell me now, my mistake. So no shame on that. Same you're going to deal with others, same. If you don't solve the problem of your ego, you cannot solve the problem with your team ego, and you cannot solve the problem also with the concerned party ego. So be humble as much as you can, okay? And this is what I think we'll do, inshallah, with the team. I'll give examples of how to be humble, inshallah. Okay? So again, this is again an example of going to the roads at night. We have lots of roads at night that had like this. After construction and after doing new construction on the road, they leave lots of things like this on the road. Okay, again, for a drunk driver, or a driver maybe he does not have proper eyesight, of course he will not. So what we did, again, same night we removed these things to clear the road and to avoid these problems. Because these roads, the guide for me in this road, this issue, not because I want all the roads of Bahrain, I'm just focusing on the black spots. Just focusing on the black spots area and removing the obstacles that I can do at minimal approach. Is this clear? Okay. So this is an example of very simple project, but it's very effective. It reduced about 50% of vehicle accidents has been reduced in these black spots. Not all Bahrain, only these black spots. Okay. We'll go another one to show you again how much your inspiration thinking can solve our problem. Can I continue? Clear? Any question? Okay. I'll continue with this and then we'll discuss, inshallah, we'll start the discussion. There is black spots also, and sewage blockages. I'm not sure. I have in our house where we are staying, relative. When we are saying we feel that you have a blockage in the sewage system. I'm not sure is it a problem in all the house or not, but we smell too much a blockage. Reclaim, I think, because it's the house maybe is lower than the Wuna River or something. I'm not sure. Okay, but anyway. The sewage blockage in Bahrain is a lot. Okay? We have lots of students, especially when we don't have lots of rain. But once we have a rain, we found the roads flood. So this was a problem again that Bahrain spent a lot of millions on that. I'll just go quickly in this, whatever written here. As I told you, I will write the challenge in English. Amar will translate you in Bosnian. These people, they used to have different type of meters. Okay? But mainly they were doing what we call corrected meters. They claim they have different type of meters. They have the corrected meter means what? Once there is a blockage, they will go as a team and solve the blockage. And you'll observe this a lot in your project, that people always are, they are what, proactive or reactive? They are always reactive, right? You'll see that most of our problems can be solved by making the mindset to be more proactive, okay? So we find, for example, that they don't have limitation of program maintenance, preventive maintenance, or what I call, this I developed myself, intensive maintenance, or reliability maintenance, or total predictive maintenance, which is prediction. Forecasting that Dr. Dunia was telling you. I cannot solve every problem, but I start to improve my forecasting or hit rates by knowing when the project will happen from which type of area. I'll tell you how I can do that. And this is a very interesting project because it will give you how much power we have as humans. What I did, I'm going to take the statistics, they had the good sets of these people. So I've taken, and see, in the traffic, I have to make the statistics, right? And do it myself in the Excel sheet. These people, they have a good statistic where blockages is happening, in which areas, at what time, okay? So they have a very good data, which is as is the only in the beginning. And they started to define where is the major blockages happening. And there are some blockages that you can solve, but they don't make too much smell. And there's areas in Bahrain, when you go to that road, you really cannot smell air. Okay, smell always sewage air and stuff. So, again, here, I started to see where is these areas, what type of problems we have. Because always remember, the issue of problem solving always will be around these four M's: manpower, method, machine, and material. Okay? You know the four M's, right? Manpower, machine, material, and method. These are the sources where we can solve our problem in a proper way. Okay? So what I want to check, I start to see where is the pumps, what type of pumps we have, and what type of pump design they have. Not only pump, are they putting pump in the floor, or they are raising the pump above the floor? Because we know when there is water, the pump has to be above the floor a little bit, right? So that it can set in a proper way. Again, what type of duration they take to solve the problem, to go to the, because sometimes if the sewage blockage stays for 2 weeks, smell will be much more like, and for example, collection of rubbish in Bihar's collection. Until yesterday, I think rubbish was not collected, okay? Because they say it is Eid, whatever, okay? So you can see the smell can increase more and more. So from here also, you can see that is what is our duration they take. Not in days, because they used to calculate it in days. What I did? I added in hours.